Cheerio.
Okay, in a few seconds, we'll have our second meeting with that weird van with the blue flashing lights and the siren. You'll hear it coming behind, well, you won't know which direction it is, but it's coming up behind us, me and this little red car, and it overtakes on the inside. Here it comes. So what is that all about, can somebody tell me? And it's heading in the same direction as I'm gonna be going. I've no idea what that is. It's not an ambulance, it looks like a bloody camper, but it's got National Health Service. It's got a siren and it's got blue flashing lights, so it's obviously classed as an emergency vehicle, but what emergency? Makes me kind of a bit suspicious. And this isn't the last time you'll see it. You'll see it once more later on in this video. Too weird to see it in three different places at three different times. Makes me very curious. If it was that much of an emergency, and it is the same vehicle, If it's that much of an emergency, this should have been wherever it's going long before I got down to where I'm going. But the fact that I saw it up the road in Blandford, and then quite a time elapsed before I got down to that roundabout, and again it comes up from behind me. So what the heck is going on with it? Nice set of roadworks there. Good old gas board out, digging a road up again. So yes, it was a rather odd experience, and it's because it was so odd that I decided to actually make a note of it, because you just don't see things like that normally. I've never ever seen that type of vehicle being used as an emergency vehicle that wasn't a police. So I don't know. I am in all sorts of speculation as to what it was all about. Who knows? It might be something to do with this COVIDiocy. Perhaps they're making out they got miracle vaccines in the back of the stupid thing or something. Who knows? But there's something not quite kosher about that. To see it three times in the same day is just too peculiar. Okay, so we're off down towards, we're not far from Poole now. We got this nice fast road. Just heading on down now towards the Upton area. Well, this is Corfmullen on the left. If you were to go up that road, that would be Corfmullen. It's quite a nice stretch of road. It's prone to accidents, unfortunately, because people do tend to put their foot down on the accelerator, disregard the bends, the dips, and up to fairly recently, some very uneven surfaces, which doesn't make for safe travelling at speed. My maximum speed for the vehicle I'm in is 50 miles an hour on any road except for a motorway. You Americans would call it a freeway. Here we call them motorways. I can legally do 60 miles an hour there. That is it. Here on these type of roads, what we call A roads, which are trunk roads, 50 miles an hour is top whack, but I generally poodle along about 40-ish. That's fast enough for me. Okay, we're coming up to a set of, no, we're not, the lights are further on down. Beg your pardon. Again, Corfmullen off to the left, passes car sales forecourt. Then we've got a set of lights at Limberlost. Not many people would know it as that now, but I remember it as that because that's what the place used to be called. There was a furniture shop that sold and made pine furniture. That place was called Limberlost, so that's how the area got its name, apparently. The shop eventually folded, the business folded, and the building still remains, although it was turned into flats, so it's a private dwelling now. But that was the name of it, Limberlost. There's a useless bit of information for you. Okay, when I've got something else to talk about, I'll come back to you.
Sneezes. No, I haven't got solid fucking lubricating or I'll be I could have catch something that don't exist. It's almost insane to say, oh, we can see galaxies, trillions of light years from here. Yeah, those are fucking bollocks. Right, we're going to go via Hammer. I think I'm going to get myself some fish and chips today. Sakura Sanju. Fucking ABS lights back on again. That's what this fucking weird. See, they got these newfangled cameras up now. That's going to cause lots of nice problems, isn't it? For a lot of non-speed obeying people. And all they got to do is write the right fucking speed. What's the problem with that?
The area that bus is just coming out of is known as Turley Moor. It's a housing estate bit less than lugubrious, shall we say, but it's not too bad. The brick arch we go under, the first one is the old Somerset and Dorset line with all the trees and vegetation growing out of it. The second one is still a live line, although it's very rarely used now. It goes down to Poole Quay. I don't know what they actually ship in and out of there by rail still, but it's very little used, and I wouldn't be surprised if it was uprooted like the Somerset and Dorset was, and it was just a bare truck bed, but at the moment it's still a live line. Okay, we are in Hamworthy now, and I'm just on my way down, hopefully towards what I'm hoping is going to be my lunch stop so I can buy some food. Unfortunately, it didn't quite work out as I planned, not from the shop that I was going to go to. I actually pull in and park up, but on arriving, as you will see, or you may see, there are maskoids, what I call mask wearers, maskoids, stood outside the shop, which I was hoping to go in and buy my lunch from. And because they stand outside like orderly little slaves, one at a time, they go in, one comes out, another one goes in. I thought, no way am I going to sit here waiting, because you don't know how many of them are queued up behind the corner. There's a small car park at the side of the shop, which you can't see. And there could be several people just stood there queuing. I thought, nah, this is ridiculous. I could be here forever. Not prepared to do that. Anyway, I'm just about to pull in this convenient little box to park on. Right, the shop on the very end, the white shop of that row of buildings on the right, is the fish and chip shop. You can see the maskoid stood there waiting to go in. I wasn't prepared to wait, so I gave it a few minutes, pulled out, and I went somewhere completely different. But you will see that in a few minutes anyway as the video progresses.